Hello, I'm Chief Meteorologist Bob Harrigan with your first alert weather update on Hurricane Beryl, the first hurricane of the season. And that's right, top winds now at 80 miles an hour, expected to get a little higher as it approaches the Lesser Antilles. You can see from the satellite imagery, it had a distinct eye earlier, but now that eye has since moved on. The system is really quite small. In fact, it's so small, you don't see many banding features at all with it at this point. So it's an unusual system, too, in that it's so far south in latitude at this point. The National Hurricane Center says it could open up to a tropical wave before it even gets close to the Lesser Antilles, or it could be a Category 1, possibly 2 hurricane. There's still a lot of uncertainty as to how intense the storm is going to be. So right now, top winds are at 80 miles an hour. It's moving to the west at 15. The pressure is at 994 millibars. And there it is, the projection for, it looks like Sunday afternoon, late or Sunday evening, coming ashore right there in the central portion of the Lesser Antilles as a Category 1 hurricane with winds up to 90 miles an hour. It's a pretty good blow, but there'll be tight area, so it won't be very wide at all. And then it makes its way south. Now, the Hurricane Center has dropped the forecast cone a little bit further off to the south with this last advisory. And in fact, they say the 11 o'clock advisory may go even a little bit further south. Now, there's some strong winds coming up from the coast of Venezuela right now out of the south. And that should really weaken the system as it moves in through the Central Caribbean and heads toward the Dominican Republic. Now, this is the cone of uncertainty. Again, we'll keep an eye on the next advisory that comes out at 11 o'clock. And in 4 days, they have the system dissipating on the fifth day. So that's good news for Florida. Don't think it's going to be a concern for us at all. We will see the possibility of some increased moisture come midweek or late week next week. All the forecast models are in pretty much agreement as of day three. But then day four and five, some keep it going west. Others take it up through the Bahamas, while others take it through Cuba. Either way, Florida is protected by all these islands in terms of getting any kind of significant storm here. Another storm the Carolinas are watching closely is this one here off of North Carolina. This could become Chris before long. In fact, the Hurricane Center has bumped up its chances to 70% over the next 2 days, 80% over the next 3 days, and will just kind of mill around in that general area before it eventually takes off into the Atlantic as a cold front moves across the Plain States. Of course, stay tuned to ABC7 as well as mysuncoast.com, and be sure to download the ABC7 weather app.